Yeah, it's GT here for another YouTube video. Today I want to kind of go over, clarify more upon the topic of so-called unity, unification, and or reunification of the Roman Catholic religious system and beast system, actually. I find it difficult to believe that using slick media techniques and slick people and you know, apparently, you know, spiritual or heartfelt tuggings at one's heartstrings and whatever, and the deception of peace. You know, in general, that pervades the popery in the Roman Catholic Church itself. Their claims that we're all worshiping the same God and all such things as that. You know, on the surface, it sounds pretty good. I mean, okay, yeah, let's everybody get together and, you know, have peace. And, you know, enjoy the brotherhood of man and, you know, why can't we all just get along, you know, kind of thing. Well, there's reasons why, and historically, there's reasons that we are separate from the Roman Catholic Church, and I'm talking in general as a Protestant. Who was brought up as a Protestant, more or less. I mean, frankly, you know, in my childhood, I remember going to church and stuff and things like that here and there. It wasn't a big part of my life. But being an American, you know, and basically from a base of Protestantism, and not really exposed or indoctrinated as a Catholic or as a Roman Catholic or any of the spin-offs, you know, that was just part of my upbringing, and my basic belief systems were formed around the people's beliefs who are in my culture. And I think that could be said for anybody who lives anywhere. They are a product of their culture and their environment for the most part. But you see, we in America, especially, you know, not in the big cities or the where the great immigrant populations predominate or are, you know, sectioned or quartered in different areas and whatever. So, you know, well, the point is that, you know, my background is quasi-Protestant as far as, like, from where I came, from whence I came, whatever. And that has, I guess, something to do with my basic belief systems. And I guess I've probably been more exposed to the evangelical Baptists and Southern Baptists, and some of my family are, I guess, a bit more, how would you say, charismatic or whatever. I don't know, but the thing is that there is this wide gap and the history of the Catholic persecution and the Catholic principles with which there is no reconciliation. You're either a Roman Catholic, or you're a Catholic, or you're not. You know, it's not, it's like, okay, are you a black man, or are you a Caucasian, or a white man, you know? I guess you could be a mulatto, but but still, there's a reason why historically and on the basic principles and the differences in the churches, and the reasons why there is a Protestant, or was a Protestant movement back, going back to, you know, Luther's day. You know, I mean, at that time, the reading of the Bible, which was closed to the Catholics previously by edict of the Pope, it was a purposeful deception so that they could retain their power. And, you know, once the Bible got in the hands of enough people and they understood quite clearly that everything the Catholic Church was doing was wrong, you know, faith by works, you know, salvation through works, you know, the many differences from the Bible that are clearly and plainly stated in the Bible, and the principles of Christianity, and even the Old Testament, you know, the Ten Commandments, the first, you know, major covenant, which that was written down in stone, is just flagrantly violated by the practices and the teachings of the Roman Catholic Church. The claim of the, you know, vicarius filii Dei the Vicar of Christ, and the claims of the Pope to be basically Christ on earth and having authority over the Bible and over mankind and over God, you know, they claim in their writings that the Pope is, you know, above God. He can change God's laws and he can change the times, and you know, they specifically claim that there is no scriptural basis for their switch from the biblical Sabbath, which they understand is not on Sunday, at least in the current calendation technique, using the current calendar, it would be on Saturday, Sabbath day, Saturday, whatever, Sabado in the Latin language, or in, you know, Spanish or whatever. They claim that it is the mark of their authority that they worship, that they changed the day of worship with no scriptural basis, and there is none. You know, if you do some research, and I know there's a lot of people who are going to say, well, we changed this because blah 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 or blah 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 blah, 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 but God never changed it. The thing is, it was instituted by the Romans first, and the Roman Catholics who took over the Roman system as a means to gather and synthesize the pagan religions of the time. And then we're going back into, you know, the 4th century. And it was just a grab of control and a power play. I've explained this, and it's quite obvious if you look in the history of the church and of the world. You know, I mean, Constantine claimed to, you know, after seeing a vision of a cross and all this, and winning a battle because of it, you know, who gave him the vision? You know, was it God or was it the devil? But the thing is that he was indeed just a pagan, a multi-theistic, you know, pagan from Roman times, and the only reason that he used Christianity was and adopted it, quote unquote, as the state religion or whatever, was so that he could maintain that theocratic aspect of control. And, you know, he was the first who really brought those pagan multi-theistic and polytheistic beliefs, which were Babylonian in nature and in origin, and he brought those together and combined it with so-called Christianity, which probably wasn't all that popular at the time, I mean, as far as numbers. But, you know, then as time went on and the Catholic Church became more and more powerful and influence and what have you, then they, you know, they too came, okay, well, we're gonna make the Sun God's winter solstice holiday, and we're gonna call it Christ Mass, and we're gonna call that Christian. Same thing with Easter, which is actually Ishtar, which is the pronunciation. Easter is the way that you pronounce it. The god, Ishtar, goddess, what have you. The Mother of Heaven, and this all goes back to Semiramis and Nimrod and Babylon and all that, you know. So these are basically just a way to incorporate and, you know, congeal the various pagan gods and god practices under the auspice of Christianity. And that way they combine all these people. You know, as long as they can take some of those practices and call them Christian, you know, then, you know, the pagans won't mind calling themselves Christians as long as they can still do their same, you know, pagan idolatry and do those practices. You know, it's a well-known fact that, you know, Saturnalia and all that, and the Bacchan festivals and all that were pagan, you know, orgies and, you know, just plain insanity in the streets. But they, you know, fold these all in under the auspice or the name of Christianity. What I want to be clear about is that the Roman Catholic system and Catholicism in itself is basically the adoption of sun god worship, which I have been stating throughout my various videos, and especially if you go back to some of my stuff on Christmas or Xmas or whatever you want to call it. You know, it's clear, and, you know, I'm not changing my views about that. I know from my research, you know, that we're talking about Babylonian religion, which is satanic in origin. It is the rebelliousness of man combined with the worship indirectly to the sun god, to Satan. So, okay, you either worship Satan and his pagan deities, or you worship God. And you worship God in the way that God says. There's two different choices there. You gotta pick one. You can't serve this master and that master. You're not a pagan and a Christian. Because if you are, it's spit you out of the mouth time. And the judgment. You know, I keep trying to emphasize the fact that people, you got to wake up and pull your heads out and understand the basis and the reality of the practices that you have adopted because of man's tradition. Okay? This is a wide path leading to perdition or to hell, whatever, destruction, death. And, you know, you can't be even considering unifying or reunifying with the Catholic religion if you're a Protestant. Okay. One thing which I must rebuke upon the so-called Protestants is that they have continued to observe the Catholic mandate of the Sunday worship, and this goes against God. They have adopted and retained the traditions of the Christmas and Easter holidays, so-called holidays. They're not holy. They certainly are not holy. They are deceptions, and they are pagan in origin, and are indeed worshiping idols and pagan idolatry practices. That is, they do not glorify God. They are not God's festivals or holidays. Nor is there any mention of either one of those main or major so-called Christian holidays, which are really, if you look at the origins of these very basic so-called holidays, they can all be traced back to pretty much Babylonian practices. Okay? You know, if you look at the symbology and the icons that represent the holidays and the practices, and you know, we just like, oh, it's Easter time, let's color some eggs, and you know, eggs, fertility rite, it just doesn't take a lot to figure it out. And one may not understand that the coloring, the original coloring of the Easter egg was after the sacrifice of the Easter babies, basically. They were typically about 3 months old. Child sacrifice on an altar, and they dipped the eggs in blood to color them red. This is what you're actually doing when you are glorifying and rededicating this pagan worship every time you do that. You know, if you what does God have to do with eggs and Easter eggs, and where does this bunny come from? Why is the bunny associated with Easter eggs? And Easter baskets and all that. Well, you know, so-called Mother of God or Mother of Heaven or whatever you want to call her, what she called herself was the goddess of the moon, she claims to drop down into the Euphrates River in an egg. And then she sprung up as a rabbit, and then, you know, these things are historically traceable, and you know, these are prime times for ceremonies and special, you know, popery and masses and whatever. So what I'm really trying to say, and I'm trying to do this, you know, rather quickly, I guess, relative to how I usually do things, which is, takes forever and I go all over the place. But the thing is that the worship of the Roman Catholics is a pagan worship. They are not even Christian. I mean, I'm not saying there's no Christians in the entire 1-point-some-odd billion people who are claimed to be Catholic, and there's probably some good people and some real Christians who actually belong in God's church. I'm not saying that, but what I'm saying is that, you know, their main thing is, you know, deceptive religion to bind and snare people into their practices, and hopefully, at least in the thoughts of the puppet master Satan, that will condemn them. That is his ultimate goal, to condemn them so he can accuse them. And he would stand there as an accuser. Well, you know, didn't you go to those Sunday worship services and that were, you know, my satanic/invented paganistic ritual? And is that not the mark that I gave you? I mean, it specifically says in the Catholic documentation and writings that is their mark of authority. Forehead and mark, you know, thoughts and deeds. Yeah. Okay, so what I'm trying to say is, you know, that religion is satanic. It is sun worship at best. And, you know, the reflection, the what you really, you know, worshiping is the devil through that. Because you got one hand, you got the devil, and the other hand, you got God. You know, which one are you going to serve? Which one are you going to pray to? And all that. Well, you know, if you confess to man instead of God, you know, like in the Catholic Church, or if you call the Pope Father, then you're not supposed to call anybody Father except God. And if you pray to saints, or if you bow down to idols of Mary and all that, then you are going against, you know, commandments of God, the real God. And not the one that they designed to capture your soul and condemn you and accuse you when it come down to the end. So when I say get out of her, I'm saying get out of that system. And I mean now. And if you're still going, if you're a so-called Protestant, and you're still doing those same practices, which is one of the main things that the Protestants had established was that the Roman Catholic Church was evil and ungodly and of man. Look at the 95 different points that Martin Luther nailed to the door of the church. Look it up. It isn't. There is not just one or two little things that separate us and keep us from reunifying or unifying or having any unity with this pagan, satanistic, humanistic, ecumenical fanatics. It's insane. they're talking unity. Islam and Muslims are our brothers, you know. And they're also in the process of kind of reunifying with the Jews, you know, through certain avenues and what have you. And they're trying to make this, it's not just them. It's the Jews, it's the Muslims, it's the Hindus, it's the Buddhists, it's everybody. They are claiming that we're all worshiping the same God. Well, to a great degree, they are. Because most, if not, predominantly, most of the world religions are basically satanic in origin, and the humanism and the Babylonian aspects, which were, you know, scattered along with the people. And I've done videos on this stuff. If you go back and look, you know, or just look it up, because, you know, the spread of the Babylonian religion and their system of religion, even though it went to different areas and was now called the gods and goddesses were called different names, it was the same exact system, you know. And it was a mimic or a counter. They're all mimics and counterfeits of Christianity. Real Christianity. And, you know, the only claim to a real, you know, any kind of really, and I hesitate to say this, but with caveats, okay, the only real religion or real church sprung out of the Protestant movement, you know, and consequently over time has become re-corrupted, and they have maintained and adopted or retained some of those aspects of the Catholic Church, making them daughters of the whore. And so I'm saying, if you are still doing those practices, the Sunday worship and all that, then you are violating the Sabbath, you know. And this may not be, you know, so destroying at this point, but there's gonna, I believe, at least the hints and the information and the rumors and the suggestions of many of the current mindset or the, you know, the overall information available is that, you know, the mark of the beast is going to be about worship. And I've seen this and had this verified on a biblical standing from the scriptures and stuff to, you know, almost certainty that it's going to have something to do with, at least in general, with worship. But then when you look at this system that's going to become the one world church and the church state of the image of the beast or whatever, which is going to be the final governmental system, and obviously is, you know, working with the UN and the Pope and all that. This system is, you know, mandating and talking, they're promoting reunification of all these various religions and all that, which is a false doctrine in and of itself, because these many were never unified or had anything to do with Roman Catholicism. But the point is that, you know, their mandate is, their mark is Sunday worship, okay? I need to make this perfectly clear. For, I'm, you know, I may not have that many people looking at my video, but hopefully I'll reach somebody to understand that Sunday worship goes against, is breaking of the Sabbath. And, you know, the times and the laws regarding when to worship and all that, these were established way back in, you know, in the history of the Catholic Church and, you know, even Rome itself, you know, going back to, like, the 4th century. I think you can look that up. It's not, it's kind of a duh thing. And it's open and available for anybody to see plainly with, you know, minimal, look it up, you know, work. Don't just believe me on anything I say, you know, test everything and look it up. This is what I always say, and I will continue to say this, because I don't want you to be deceived by any man. Let no man deceive you. Do not be deceived. Let you be deceived. You know, we go along bouncing off the walls, la la la, through our everyday life. We have no idea what we're doing. We're just doing everything that everybody else does. You know, it's traditions, traditions of man. God said, you know, why do you go to there following the traditions of man and calling it, you know, worshiping me? I spit you out. I don't know you. I don't know you. You cry, Lord, Lord. I don't even know you. But didn't we do miracles in your name and blah blah blah? Well, yeah, but I didn't know you. You know, I mean, it's pretty clearly stated, you know, the path is narrow, not wide, you know, like a hot dog down the highway. It don't work too good. You know. But okay. My points are, number one, Roman Catholic Church is a conglomeration of paganistic, satanistic, and Babylonian practices, which goes back, way back, to the devil. And, you know, their sisters in pagan worship and all that, like, you know, Lutherans and Methodists and all that, they're already gone back. You know, they've made agreements. Oh, well, you know, it's grace and works, you know. And now they're going after the evangelicals and the Baptists and the charismatics and all that. And I'm not even sure, you know, how faithful any of these other little sects or denominations or whatever are, if they're close to God or not, you know, or if it's just spiritualist, humanistic, you know, worldly crap that divides them. I don't know, but, you know, if they unify or reunify with the Catholic Church, then, you know, I'm going to condemn and rebuke them. And if you are a member of those and you're in that system, then I'm going to urge you to get out of her now. You know, this is a warning, and it's not really coming from me. I mean, it's indirectly, but, you know, get out of her. When they institute, what is most important is to understand that the future and the worship and the mark of the beast, you know, for maybe for right now and all that, you just need to be learning and understanding and comprehending the gospel and, you know, getting to know and to seeking God and His ways rather than the ways of man and the ways of the churches or the religions or any of that. The Bible, King James Version, not watered down, not changed, not altered, intact, you know, sanctified. And I believe it still retains as much the word that you're going to get. And there's other, you know, books that have been replaced and usurped. And there's a lot of things that probably, I'm not going to say they should be in the Bible because they're not. But you can learn other, okay, I'm going to take all that back. I don't know. I'm just going to say that, you know. But one has to understand that the people who ultimately determine what your Bible was going to be made up of was from the Roman Catholic Church. And you know, I mean, it would be a miracle of God, and indeed it probably is, that the Bible is what it is and how it is. But it's possible that, you know, there was things in those other books that we might have wanted to see or needed to see or understand. Some are referenced even like, you know, the Book of Enoch and the Book of Jasher and stuff like that. You know, they difference. So why they were discluded, disincluded, or whatever. You know, that's a mystery to me, you know. But, and I don't want to go into that, really. But the thing is, you still have a Bible that is true to God's Word and is, I believe, is at least the majority of it is, you know, I mean, I don't want to get myself in trouble here. I mean, I'm going to say that I believe the King James Bible is as close as you're going to get to the real thing. And if you look at some of the, I believe, look up New World Order Bible versions or something like that, you can see a pretty good video on how the distortions in the newer translations and stuff, how they leave things out, how they reword things and all that. So that's a warning to you, do you know, because you can get infected by the, you know, the difficulties of translations, and I think purposeful alterations and doctrine changes which occur over time because of the new translations. And, you know, that good old King James Version is mighty fine. I'll just say that. I mean, you know, you can understand that it took a few these and thous and, you know, whatever, but it's sometimes you need those in there to understand the context, or, you know, the personhood, or what's going on. Anyway, I don't want to digress too much. The thing is, I'm trying to say is that the Roman Catholic Church is basically evil, okay? It's run by Satan. The Pope is the Antichrist. Each Pope is another Antichrist. There's been many. It's pretty clear, you know, these are Antichrist, or the false prophet, or both, you know. And, you know, you want to be in the devil's church? You want to reunify with that? Do you want to unify with the devil? No, you idiots. If you said yes, I don't know, you know, what planet you're on. It is so obvious. It's pagan. It's Babylonian. The Babylon. I keep thinking Babylon, Babylon, Babylon. Okay. Rome. Catholic. Babylon, consider, associate them, okay? Get it straight in your head. You don't want any part of a unification with them, as well as any of those other religions, you know, Islam, Hindu, Buddhist, meditational, who knows what kind of crapola, humanistic, Satan-inspired, you know. And like I said, they can all unify because they're all Satanistic. They're all humanistic, Satan-based, Babylonian-based, so-called religions, and that's how and why they can all unify. And that is also why they demonize the evangelical Christians and the Protestants, and have been for quite a few years now. And they're calling us in the United States extremists, and hate speechers, and hate mongers, and they're trying to demonize Christians in the military, and you know, and they're radical hate mongers, you know, they're horrible. And be prepared for persecution to come, because we're not gonna go down their little reunification trip avenue. We're not gonna go with that. And then we're gonna become persecuted. And it's gonna be just like, you know, the Dark Ages all over again, only they might be a little bit more humane in their torture, but in the end, there's guillotine for you. You know, if you get caught, they decide to hook on to your, oh, that guy, he's not going to the mandated Sunday worship, and he's not bound to the beast, the image of the beast. We're gonna have to get that sucker, you know, and we'll, you know, line them up, chop chop, with some of the 30,000 guillotines that are rumored to be already in the United States. I don't know if that's true or not, but hey. Also supposed to have, you know, railroad cars with shackles already ordered up and all that. You can look those up too, you know, see what you think about it. I don't know. My point here is that, you know, there's, okay, Martin Luther nailed 95 points difference for his reformation. Wasn't one point, wasn't just about works and faith, you know, or grace. It was 95 different points that the Catholic Church had, you know, did practices that disagreed with the Bible, which is the Word of God and, you know, the way that we're supposed to do things. And they're not doing it. They haven't been doing it, and they never will do it. They're doing things their way, and they're using their authority, and they're usurping the authority of God, and they claim to be God on earth. And, you know, Vicarious Fili Dei comes out to be 666, and the Antichrist, the Mark of the Beast, Sunday worship, this has to do with worship, you know. I'm pretty convinced. I think most other people are too at this point. You know, at one point it was like, what? What's this all? What do you mean? You know, I thought it was going to be one of those chips, and, you know, apparently not, you know. You know, that may be used as, you know, a control structure thing or whatever, but the mark is about your, you know, your thoughts and your deeds, your head or your hand. And if you accept the mark, and, you know, it's going to be mandated, just like back in, you know, the days of Nebuchadnezzar in Babylon. You know, when he defied God, he said, well, no, I'm going to make a statue, and it's going to be all, you know, gold all the way up and down, you know. It's not going to be like God says. And everybody's going to have to worship this sucker, you know. I'm going to call some music, and when the music comes on, yeah, everybody bows in the direction of that statue. Does that sound familiar about bowing to, you know, direction, whatever, and the music? That all kind of like ring a bell with some Middle Eastern type stuff. Well, you know, and there was three men stood up and said, nope, not gonna bow to this idol. because it goes against my worship, my worship in my God. And my God says, no, don't do it. Well, to the furnace with those, you know. And they went in the furnace. And you know what? They came out of the furnace. And I believe when three went in, when they came in there, when they went in there, they could swear that there was four people in there. You know? So, if you be righteous and defy the new Babylon or the new mark of the beast and the new world, you know, I'm not saying that your life, your bodily life, is going to be spared, but your eternal life. I would gladly, you know, give my unworthy body and life to my Lord Jesus and for my Father by not denying them myself, you know. I mean, each of you will have to make up your own mind about that. But when you see the call, when you see the evolution of these things that are currently under consideration and in the process of occurring, when you see it happening and they mandate the Sunday worship thing or the bowing down or to whatever image of the beast, they end up having that even talks, you know, who knows what kind of deception it's going to really be, but it's pretty well basically put in the Bible, you know. When those things happen, then you have to come out of her or you will be damned. You know, it's gonna be all the religions, all the denominations, all the different sects are all going to be doing the same thing at that time. Get out of her before that time. Get out of her, as far as I'm concerned, you know. And you Protestants who are in churches that are deifying and glorifying and holidayifying on Christmas and Easter and things like that, or if you're still sacrificing, you know, basically yourselves, I'm rebuking you, and I am asking people now in the Protestant churches to reform or get out of her before you get sucked in. And you know, the time, who knows when it's going to be exactly when the amnesty's over. You know, are you going to be sucked into it because you already worship on Sunday? Now, I'm still working on the lunisolar calendation and all that, as far as working that out. I'm not sure exactly. You know, I do know that, you know, God's festivals will continue and his Sabbath will be honored during the millennium after the second coming. but I'm not sure. It seems to be somewhat hidden away from us.
It's 8 o'clock.
Kind of took it away. I believe there's a reason for that. And you know, maybe it's being prideful or separationist to even think or do those things. I don't know. I'm somewhat confused, and I'm sure that's a function of the devil, confusion, because God, you know, is not the author of confusion. So, you know, might be a blockage there. Maybe there's, you know, I'm not up there enough to understand it. I don't know. But at this point, I'm, you know, I'm going to leave the law over there and wait and see. But I know one thing for sure, you know, when the beast, and they talking about worshiping this beast or this idol or whatever it is, and it has to be done on Sunday, I'm sure, because that's the whole popery thing. And the unification of all these satanic, paganistic religions, and the persecution of those who won't, which is probably the Protestants and the, you know, the evangelicals, which they're demonizing now, you know, just wait, and it's time for, you know, they might start burning people at the stake, who knows? And they'll be doing it in the name of God, in their minds. You know, hey, everybody else is together with this, you know, this unification thing. Why aren't you? Because you're evil, you know? Anybody who isn't like everybody else is demonized. So I'm just gonna, you know, warn you. Come out of her now, or come out of her soon. When the feces fan convergence occurs, or your soul in real trouble. So, I want to admonish you on that point. I want to rebuke those who are continuing on with their paganistic ceremonies and holidays and the principles and practices that they carried on from the Whore of Babylon Church, Roman Catholic Church. I want to warn you against the whole unification / reunification / unity / peace brigade being formed and promoted by the Pope and the New World Order and the UN and all the insane politicians who are jumping onto it and all the insane TV preachers like Kenneth Copeland, Jeweler, and freaking Billy Graham, and you know, get out of those now. they're killing your soul, they're damning you. Get out of her, people. I'm going to cut this off here. I'm going to wish you peace, love, and power, and may blessings of God be upon you. In the name of Jesus.